On today's episode, wind power returns to ocean shipping. Today's episode is brought to you by engineering.com, a globally trusted source for engineering content. Check out this and many other exclusive videos for the engineering professional found only on engineering.com TV today. For thousands of years, the movement of bulk commodities has been about ocean shipping under sail. But for the last two centuries, steam and diesel power have been the prime movers of choice. But in the age of CO2 reduction, wind is becoming relevant again. Cargill, a very large global producer of bulk agricultural commodities, has partnered with BAR Technologies and MC Shipping to retrofit a large cargo vessel with vertical airfoils to augment propeller propulsion. The ship, Pyxis Ocean, was retrofitted with what BAR Technologies calls WindWings and has been under test at sea since August 2023. The 37-meter-tall solid steerable sails are deployed electrically from the bridge, with a simple traffic light system telling the crew when to raise or lower the sails. Once deployed, onboard sensors help adjust the sails for optimal configurations. The goal is not to replace diesel propulsion, but to supplement it, allowing lower throttle settings to maintain a desired steady-state speed. Under optimum conditions, BAR reports that Pyxis Ocean can achieve fuel savings of 11 tons per day. On average, savings of 3 tons of fuel per sailing day have been measured, and approximately 14% fuel saving. In terms of emissions, under optimal conditions, the vessel emits 41 tons a day less CO2 measured well to wake, a 37% savings. Measured annually, with 237 sailing days per year, 2,650 tons less CO2 is released, the equivalent of removing 480 cars from the road. Pyxis Ocean is a Kamsarmax vessel chartered from MC Shipping, a designation that indicates a ship capable of using the large port of Kamsar in Guinea, West Africa. Kamsarmax ships can be as large as 100,000 tons deadweight, and BAR expects to deploy 3 WindWings on future conversions. The conversion work on Pyxis Ocean was done at Costco in Shanghai, China in 2023. With 6 months of real-world testing complete, results are similar to those predicted by simulation, and Cargill is examining 250 ports worldwide to determine where similarly equipped bulk carriers could be berthed. The International Maritime Organization has urged shippers to achieve 5% of all energy to be derived from very low-carbon sources by 2030. The results suggest that wind-assisted propulsion could achieve these goals on the big Kamsarmax-sized ships. As the driver of the project, Cargill is the customer rather than the shipping service provider and has considerable power to drive the technology forward. The company typically charters 650 vessels worldwide. Pyxis Ocean has demonstrated the viability of wind-assisted power, and the path is now open for large-scale deployment across the shipping industry worldwide. Well, that's it for today's episode of This Week in Engineering, brought to you by engineering.com. For our deeper engineering series, visit engineering.com TV for exclusive shows like Manufacturing the Future, Designing the Future, and the Engineering Roundtable, not found on our YouTube channel. The links are in the description below. Thanks for watching.